Are you sure there's a shiny Moltres up here?
Oh yeah.
Why didn't we remote raid pass up here? Fortune's got us all out of shape.
Yo, Chaz and Becky, welcome back to Legendary Adventures. My name is Eli, aka that big sauce gamer tag.
And I'm Becky, aka Small Fry.
And squad, we are here to go ahead and help you take down the one and only shiny Moltres.
Woo!
Now, coming back to tier 5 raids is the shiny Moltres. Regular Moltres with the possibility of a shiny.
Right.
Let's go ahead and dive into that, right?
Yes.
So, before we actually give you the counter, guys, before we go ahead and give you the nitty-gritty of the information, I want to go ahead and let you know that if you like Pokemon raid counter, guys, Pokemon Go vlogs, Pokemon Go perfect IVs and community tips and other Pokemon Go news, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe button, smash the notification bell so you can go ahead and join us on our legendary adventures. But with that said, let's go ahead and get the info on
Moltres.
Alright, so perfect IV Moltres, what are we looking at?
We're looking at 1980 non-weather boosted.
Now, what's a weather boosted by?
By sunny and windy weather, and that perfect is 2475.
Woohoo! Which means we have sunny skies in California. Well, actually, when don't we? But what that means, hopefully you have sunny skies in your area, and if you're hoping to get a weather boosted one and would like to go ahead and join part of the squad, just go ahead and drop your gamer code in the comments down below. And if we got to the space, we'll add you in as we try to circulate everyone on the legendary squad members to go ahead and put raid with us. But with that said, let's dive into it.
Can this be soloed?
I'd like to know. Now, the Mega Glitch says yes till Niantic fixes that, but we won't dive into that because I want to chat with you all about that. But with that said, no, it is not soloable. Is it doable? It is a doable Pokemon, definitely for sure. All right, squad. So do note, since Moltres is a fire flying type, it takes 2x damage or is 2x weak to rock. Now, it is weak to electric and water, and we do have some of those mixes in the mix, but for the most part, we're going to be running with a heavy rock squad to go ahead and bring it down. Now that you know what the perfect IVs are, before we dive into the counters, do note that we did not touch on the shadows for this. Why? Because shadows are pricey. Shadow Pokemon are pricey. Then if you weren't able to go ahead and get them with the move removed during the Pokemon Team Rocket Go events that they have, where you can go ahead and TM the frustration off, and then of course add on a community day move, well, it's pricey. It makes it hard to go ahead and do so. We want you to go ahead and have the most accessible team to go ahead and bring down Moltres.
So we are going to mention them just real quick. It's Shadow Tyranitar and Legacy Shadow Amistar.
Yikes. See, all that. Pricey.
Okay, but let's move on to the Supreme Moltres counter.
Ooh, I'm Burrito Supreme.
All right, coming in
and
at...
And I'm not just Supreme.
Coming in at number one is actually Rampardos with Smackdown and Rock Slide.
It hurts my heart every time I hear it because Rhyperior is number one in my heart as a rock boy. But Rampardos is vicious. It's tanky. It's strong.
It only takes 50 candies to level him up to Rampardos. So that's the plus side on that one.
Okay. All right. Maybe I should build my army around that. And coming in at number two, now for all my trainers that I've been playing from day one, and for the new trainers, this one's a little bit easier to go ahead and acquire out in the wild most days. Hold on, I'm gonna go with most days, but this happens to be Titar.
Woo!
Now Tyranitar in itself coming down with Smackdown and Stone Edge, so this will cost you an elite TM move in order to go ahead and get that, as Stone Edge is a community day move.
So Rampardos and Tyranitar are beasts, and you're gonna want to run them in your duo teams as they prey on double weakness to rock types.
Yep. So can you go ahead and duel it? Yes, you can. Can you go ahead and take it on individually? Perhaps with a Mega Glitch, but we're not going to talk about that. But maybe we can make a video about that. But we're not going to talk about that right now.
Okay,
so,
awesome.
With that said, coming in at number three is number one in our hearts. And, of course, it is Rhyperior. Rhyperior going in with...
Smackdown and Stone Edge.
Boom!
Non-community day move. So I have a whole bunch of those.
Now, that's a great one. This is the one that's going to be most accessible if you can build your A team and your B team with it. Because, well, it is easier. I'm just going to go with that. Now, coming in at number four, we're looking at the
Legacy
move.
Amistar with Rock Throw and Rock Slide.
Ooh. Now, Amistar is nice. But, that Legacy move, an elite charge move. Pricey. So I don't know. If you are running with a team of six, let me know in regards to that. I know that I maybe at best have two or three. So
same here. And the next one I'm really excited that he came into the lineup is Golem with Rock Throw and Stone Edge. Yes.
Kanto's other heavyweight favorite.
He's so dope.
And what makes it go Golem great for this one in itself is because, you know, with trading with someone else, a Graveler or a Geodude, you just nullify the 100 candies to go ahead and have to use to, well, evolve them. Yeah. So with that said, that's 100 candies you can use to go ahead and power up and use. So maybe for the price of what would be one Rhyperior, you can go ahead and get two of the Golems.
Moving on to the good Moltres raid counters, we're looking at Regirock with Rock Throw and Stone Edge.
Boy, does it hit.
It's bulky one.
It is powerful. It is one to definitely use. Going into the next one.
Lunatone with Rock Throw and Rock Slide.
Ooh, all right. So Lunatone gets some play in here. And since we've had some recent events with Lunatone and the upcoming next one.
Solrock with Rock Throw and Rock Slide. That's awesome.
It's going to be a great arsenal. What I'm like so excited about this so far is that there is a plethora of rock type Pokemon, a plethora of Pokemon to just utilize. So it's going to be a great diverse team to go ahead and be raiding.
So the next one is a whole bunch of people's favorite Rayquaza with Dragon Tail and Ancient Power.
Rayquaza! Now, do be aware that it is slightly glassy. Bam!
Thank you guys so much for watching. Comment down below who's going to be in your raid party. We are really excited for Moltres to be coming back and we're ready to take it on.
Time to get another shiny! Alright squad, so with that said, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe button, smash the notification bell, and we'll catch you all in the next Legendary Adventures.
Peace!
Deuce!